successful. We did a series of events and actually got our friends in Malaysia to kind of start a nonprofit as well. So,
right. And that's what it is all about. And basically, we don't do enough here in the United States. We're doing a lot outside. Not that helping the people in Japan with the tsunami.
We need to help people here first.
There's an article going around right now that I sent up to some of my friends that we need to do more here. And not that to stop what's going out in the other countries, but there's a lot of people who are in hungry, the hunger issue, they're homeless, they need jobs, and we need to do more. And that's what the artists, we have raised money for several different charities, as well as several organizations.
No, I definitely believe in the fact of if you're doing well, go back to your community, give back, share the wisdom. There's enough wisdom for everyone to share. There's enough money to be shared. It's just greed takes over, but that's another show. but basically, what I'm saying is the fact that you give back when you have is a great thing. And having people employed right now is very important. And being these artists will get employment from whatever gallery or they're painting a sale, that's having movements with the flow of money. So I guess it's one step, but if everyone else does it, it's one step to fixing a problem. Because everyone says, how can we change? And to bring change, sometimes they feel you have to be major, you have to have a massive amount of money, or you have to have a business. But what I'm saying is one artist can make a difference in his artwork to help people in the times that we're living in today to give motivation and inspiration, but as well as also help the other businesses because you're working with the other businesses and they get exposure. Correct. So everyone wins. Mm-hmm. That's where I'm coming from. Yeah. And I was trying to...
That's perfect what you said.
Right. You know,
to bring about change, people have got to spend money. People to the artists, they will spend. They will spend it on canvas, they will spend it on paint. So the money goes back to the community. So that's what we need to do.
Well, not only give money to the artists, give money to the organizations, the charities, the different businesses. You know, be a part of helping your local community, the businesses, because they need the help right now to keep, you know, to do better. We have 3 minutes, actually, 2 minutes probably right now before we close. Is there any closing thoughts anyone want to wish the viewers right now?
Well, this is going to be showing just before I'm Jewish, so for Hanukkah as Christmas, Kwanzaa, all of them. So enjoy the holidays, make it merry, and if you can, share it with somebody who is in need.
Merry Christmas, Hugh. Mom and Dad.
I just want to say thank you, Linda, for having me on the show, and Mark and Renato, and Jake for having me as well.
That's cool.
Thanks for all the support.
Thanks, Linda.
And what about, would you like to?
Yes, thank you, Linda, for having us here. It's good energy.
Special
here.
Thanks.
That's great.
And just want to say to the audience to just stay positive. Just keep doing your thing.
Yeah, you know, you'll be back again. We have a lot more things that we could let the audience know that they probably don't know that is involved in, you know, getting the community on track and with the art.
Yeah.
How everything is involved. Thank you so much for being here today. Thank you so much
for
watching the Finding Wisdom show. Please stay tuned for our new schedule in January. We'll be changing. On Thursday and Friday, we'll be on. On Thursday nights, we'll be on channel 35. And Friday nights, we'll be on channel 56 at 11 p.m. to 12 p.m. Thank you so much for watching. Have a Merry Christmas from the Finding Wisdom Show and the Art of Terang. Happy Hanukkah also, and Kwanzaa that will be coming up. Enjoy the holidays. Be safe, and God bless. You can do that.
You can do that.
Yeah. Good. Good. We'll be right back.
Ah.